Children, now let us see the book exercise, vocabulary, singular and plural. Children, I hope you all know what is singular and plural. Singular in the sense single, one. Plural in the sense many. We have seen how to form plural from singular for certain nouns, and now we are going to see the other forms of plurals. So let's get started, children. Some nouns become plural when we change the vowels. So you all know what are the vowels we have: a, e, I, o, u. So here the singular man changes into plural form men. Man changes into men when it turns into plural. Foot, feet. Tooth, teeth. Goose, geese. Okay, so USS changes into I. Cactus, cacti. Fungus, fungi. Syllabus, syllabi. Okay, ISS changes into ES. Hypothesis. So ISS changes into ES by pronouncing hypothesis. Oasis, oasis. Crisis, crisis. So UM changes into A. Bacterium, singular deer. When you change into plural, it's a bacteria. Medium, media. Curriculum, curricula. Okay. Passerby. So it comes into passers by. Sister-in-law, sisters-in-law. Don't write as the sister-in-laws. Okay, it's a wrong answer. So the plural form of sister-in-law is sisters-in-law. Brother-in-law, brothers-in-law. Runner-up, runners-up. Okay, so some noun have same form for plural and singular. They have a same form for both singular and plural. For example, deer, deer. It is not deers. It's a deer, deer. Fish, fish. Hair, hair. Furniture, furniture. Luggage, luggage. Okay, so we are going to write the plural form for the given words. Yes. So the plural form for the food is food. Radius, I told you, US will be changed into I. So it is radii. Governor general. So if we get the hyphenated, we'll get governors general. Syllabus, US, syllabi, I. Datum, UM, if we get, we'll be writing into A, data. Commander in chief. So commanders in chief. Thesis, thesis, IS will change into ES. Forum, fora. Cattle, same word, cattle. Genius, geniuses or genii. Okay, children. So now let us see the compound word. So what is compound word? Compound words are formed when two or more words are put together to form a new word with a new meaning. So if we add two or more words to the given words which is already there, it will give you a new word. That is what is the compound word. By seeing example, definitely you'll understand, children. So once again, we'll see what is compound word. Compound words are formed when two or more words are put together. When it is added to the word, it will give you a new word with a new meaning. Say head. So head is different. When we add words master to that, it will give you a new meaning, a new word, that is headmaster. Headmaster is different from head, is it? Okay. Keyboard. Together, keyboard. That is what is the compound word. Cell phone, cell phone. School boy, school boy. So eye plus sight, eyesight. Home is different, work is different, together homework. Moon plus light, moonlight. Note plus book, it's a notebook. So now let us see some important compound words using gerund plus noun. Children, you all know what is gerund. I'll tell you now. A gerund is an action word that ends in ing. So it's an action word. We all know action word is nothing but verb. It ends with ing, and it will function as a noun. It will function as a noun. It will end with ing and it will function as a noun. Okay, children, that is what is known as gerund. Okay, so dining plus hall together, dining hall. Washing plus machine is washing machine. Waiting plus hall, waiting hall. Driving plus school, it's a driving school. Walking plus stick, it's a walking stick. drawing room, drawing room. So calling bell together, it's a calling bell. Baking, it's different. Soda is different. Together, it will give you a new word, baking soda. Okay, so now let us see some important compound words using noun plus verb. You all know what is noun. Noun is the naming words, that is the name of a person, place, animal or thing. And verbs, you all know, it's action words. Whatever work we do or work done, it is called as the verb. Okay, noun, snow plus verb fall, it's nothing but snowfall. Car plus park, a car park. Book plus mark, book mark. Sun is different, set is different. Together, it's a sunset, new word. Cat walk, it's quite different, is it? Cat is different, walk is different. Together, it's a cat walk. What the modeling do, models do, is it? Rain plus fall, rainfall. Haircut, toothache. Okay, children. So now, let us find the compound words and write them in that dashes. You will be writing this in your textbook. Actually, children, it is in the format of match the following and you are going to match this. Shall I give this as the homework? You will do this. It's very easy. You will be doing it and you can check your answer in the PDF. Okay, children? Yes. Okay. Choose the best answer to make a correct compound word. Which can be placed after soft? After soft, soft play, software, soft run or soft cycle. The right answer is software. Okay. Which can be placed before light? Twilight, sunlight, horse light or cat light. The right answer is sunlight. Okay. Third question. Which can be placed after safe? Safe chair, safeguard, safe shop. And your right answer is, a safe van is also given as the option. And the right answer is safeguard. Fourth, which can be placed after blue? Blue cane, blueprint, blue sea, blue land. And the right answer is blueprint. Fifth question, which can be placed after water? Water food, water stick, waterfall, or water out. The right answer is waterfall. Okay, children. So we have completed the unit 2 notes. Children, now let us discuss what is prefix and suffix. See, always I have told you several times, when you get the question, read the question at least 2 to 3 times so that you will get the idea. So by reading the question, prefix and suffix, you will get some idea. Prefix, suffix. So we are going to prefix, that is for the prefix, I'm going to add some words before to it. That is what prefix. And I'm going to add some words after the main word. That is what is the suffix. Children, let us discuss in detail to understand better. Yes. So what is prefix? A prefix is an affix which is placed before the root word. Adding to it to the beginning of the one word changes it into another word. For example, when the prefix an, un, an is added to the word happy, it creates the new word unhappy. See here, children, actually in English grammar, a prefix is a set of letters which we add before the main word or root word to make a new word, to give a new word that can change the meaning of the word itself, okay? Which will change the meaning of the word. Let us see the example, happy. Happy is the word. When we hear this word happy, obviously we all feel that, oh, this particular person is happy. And I'm going to add some words to the happy, that is un. And the meaning here, it changes completely. That is what is the prefix. Prefix. Okay, children. So what is the prefix? When a set of letters is added before the main word or root word, it will give you a new word that can change the meaning of the word itself. Yes, children. So let us discuss the example now. Now let us discuss the examples. Yes, children, are you all ready?
Okay, so when the word prefix re, R-E, and the meaning of re is, and re means writing once again, is it? Okay, when the word re is added to the root word write, we get the new word rewrite, that is write once again. Okay, in the same way, when the prefix word that is added by is added to the root word cycle, we get a new word bicycle. In the same way, when the set of letters that is prefix an is added to the root word expected, and we get a new word that is unexpected. So let us discuss the meaning of these things. Okay, what is the meaning of re, what is the meaning of an, we'll discuss now. Okay, the word re and the meaning of re, R-E, is again, doing the thing once again. And the example and the new word is rewrite. Next, the word an, and the meaning of an is not, and it will give you a new example, and it will give you an example, unkind. The word prefix pre, and the meaning of pre is before, and the example is pre-reading. The word prefix this, and the meaning of this is not, D-I-S, that, okay, this, and the meaning of this is not, and it will give, and the new example is disrespect. The word prefix im, and the meaning of im is not, and the new example is impossible. And the example is impossible. The word prefix non, and the meaning of non is not, and the example is nonsense. Okay, the word prefix miss, and the meaning of miss is wrong, and the example is misbehave. Some more example we'll discuss, children. Okay, anti, the meaning of, there is the prefix anti, and the meaning of word anti is against or opposed to, and the word example, that is the example is, the new word is antidote. Okay, the word prefix co, and the meaning of co is with, and the word is co-worker, and one more example is co-sister also we can say. Okay, the word prefix this, and the meaning of this is opposite of, that is disagree. The word ill, and the meaning of ill is not, okay, and it'll give you a new meaning, illegal. Legal means going everything in a legally, illegal completely not legal work, that is what illegal. Okay, the word miss, and the word of the meaning of the word miss is wrongly. Okay, M-I-S, miss, and the word meaning of it, meaning is wrongly, and the new word is misunderstand. The word non, and the meaning is without, the new word is nonsense. The word prefix pre, meaning is before, the new word is preview. The word prefix is re, and the meaning is again. So the new word is rediscovered. Next example, semi, the meaning of word semi is half, and the new word is semicircle. Circle is different, semicircle is different. Okay, the word prefix an, and the meaning is not, and the new word is unfinished. Okay, children, I hope you have understood what is prefix. Okay, so children, you will be completing this exercise. Ye, underline the prefix in each word in the boxes. So for, let us discuss the first example, unlock. So lock is different. Okay, lock is locking something. Okay, when I'm adding the set of letter an to the word unlock, it gives you a new meaning. So here UNN is the prefix, so you can underline the word UNN. Okay, children, in the same way, other examples you will do it by yourself in the homework notebook. It is the homework for you now. Okay, now let us discuss what is suffix. A suffix is an affix which is placed after the root word. These suffixes changes the meaning or grammatical function of the new word. In English grammar, a suffix is a set of letters which we add at the end of the main word or root word to make a new word, to give a new word that can change to fit grammatically within the sentence. I hope, children, you have understood what is suffix. Children, suffix is a set of letter which we add at the end of the main word or root word to make a new word. Okay, so that can change grammatically to fit within the sentences. So that is what is the suffix. Okay, it can change itself to fit grammatically within the sentence. For example, see, happy is the root word and I'm going to add the suffix -ness and it gives you a new word, happiness. So color is the word, root word, and I'm going to add the suffix -ful and it will give you a new word, colorful. So friend is the root word, I'm going to add the suffix -ship and it will give you a new word, friendship. In the same way, let us discuss some more example with the meaning, children, so that you will understand better. Okay, so I'm going to take the suffix able, and the meaning of able is can be done. It can be done anything. Able, I'm able to do anything. That is what can be done. And the new example and the new word is comfortable. Al, having the character of personal. Ed, past tense, traveled. Okay, so the past tense of travel is traveled. I'm going to add ed to that. Okay, then the next example is n. Meaning of n is made of. That is wooden. Okay, example is wooden. Okay, next suffix example is est, to compare. And the example is strongest. Okay, the next suffix example is less. And the meaning of less is without. Meaning of less is without. And the new word is homeless. Next suffix example is -ness, and the meaning of -ness is state of being, and the new word is sickness. Okay, next suffix word is -y, characterized by, and the new word is beauty. Okay, children? Yes. So here too they have given you some more example. Fat plus er is the fatter. Drive plus ing, driving. It will give you a new word, driving. Change plus able, changeable. Use plus less, useless. There is a vast difference between the use and less, useless. Beauty plus full, beautiful. Lie plus ing, lying. Children, now let us complete the B. Pick a suitable prefix and suffix from the given box and complete the following words. So they have given you certain words in the box and you will be completing this by yourself. This is also the homework for you. You can write this homework in your homework notebook. Okay, children, I hope you have understood what is suffix and what is prefix. So this is very easy and you will be getting like this type of questions till 10th standard. Yes, children, so in this session we have learnt what is singular, plural, and what is homophones, and then suffix and prefix. Okay, children, I hope I have completed the book exercise of unit 2, 3 and 4. In the next session we will be learning what is INS development, how to make notice making and letter writing. Okay, children, till then take care. Be safe. Thank you, children.